Welcome to the Terms and Conditions for T&C Catalog Action Training Module of the FAS Catalog Platform, or FCP, Vendor Training Series. In this module, we will discuss when and how to create a T&C action, how to publish the T&C file update. When and how to create a T&C action. The last FCP approved terms and condition file displays on the catalog overview page. If no file displays in this section, then that means an FCP T&C catalog action has not yet been approved. To create an FCP T&C file update catalog action, no other catalog actions can be in progress. These actions include seller profile update, adds, changes, deletes, and TPR actions. Once any in-progress actions are considered closed, then the vendor can create a new T&C file update action. In this example, there is a seller profile action in progress. A validation error message displays, as shown here, and the vendor must either wait until the seller profile action is complete, or if the action is not needed, can remove the seller profile action from the catalog. When ready to create the T&C file update action, the vendor must link an awarded EMOD modification to the FCP action. The EMOD ID drop-down menu pre-populates with all awarded FCP applicable modification types. If you cannot find the EMOD modification you expect, please double-check the mod in EMOD to make sure it is awarded. If you are not sure which modification to select, work with your CSCO to determine which recently awarded modification should be linked to the T&C action. Select the modification from the EMOD ID drop-down menu and press the Continue button to create the FCP action. How to process the T&C action. Using the FCP file uploader, the vendor uploads a new T&C file. Press the Submit button to process the FCP action through to the pending CSCO review workflow state. The CSCO receives an email notification that the T&C action is ready for their review. The CSCO then performs their review. When ready to submit a determination, the CSCO can either approve, which sends the file for processing and publishing to GSA Advantage, request clarifications, which sends the action back to vendor to make edits and resubmit back to the CSCO for re-review, or reject, which automatically updates the FCP action status to rejected and ends the workflow. In the case of rejection, the vendor would need to initiate a new terms and conditions file update action in FCP. Additionally, for any determination path, the CSCO can input a comment which will be saved to the action and sent to the vendor. Comments will be helpful in the case of clarifications or rejections so that the vendor can better understand the reasoning for the determination. For our training demonstration, I will select Approve for this action. Pressing the Submit Determination button, the action updates to read-only, and the status now displays as pending submission validation. The FCP system is processing the file. After processing is complete, the action status updates to T&C processing, where the T&C file is placed in the publishing queue, which can take several days to complete. Once the T&C file update action is successfully published to Advantage and eLibrary, the vendor receives an email notification indicating the action is published. The FCP action status updates to Published on Advantage, seen here in the closed catalog action status. The currently approved terms and conditions file automatically regenerates with the approved T&C file, and the vendor can now proceed with creating other FCP catalog actions. Time for a knowledge check. True or false? Terms and conditions updates should be linked to an applicable awarded modification. True. The T&C should be linked to the modification associated to the T&C update. Example, if you recently completed an add send modification, link that closed modification. If multiple modifications are related to the T&C update, associate the most appropriate mod or consult your CSCO. This concludes the T&C update training module. Thank you for watching.